Welcome back to Athens, Greece, as we move to opening heats in the men's 100. Maurice Greene of the U.S. taking the track. The U.S. has long dominated the sprints, but now looking for someone to keep the tradition alive. Raw speed. It supplies the vitality of any track meet. The swiftest of foot are the ones who remain etched in our memory. American sprinters today run with extra weight, the baggage of an unparalleled championship tradition in track and field's glamour event, the 100 meters. Carl Lewis was the last of the legacy. No new face has emerged from his shadow. And lately there's been more talk than titles, empty words unmatched by deeds.
This is what it's all about! It's about
death! The world has had an opportunity to come and experience what we've experienced in the USA. The coaches, the facilities, the technologies, the weight training, and they've taken it back and represented their country.
Virtually all of these leading international sprinters train part or full time in America, including the latest sensation, Trinidad's Otto Bolden.
I just think that the U.S. is going through a little change, and the older guys are getting older, the Lewis's and the Mitchells and so on. They're in the twilight of their careers, and the Maurice Greens and the Tim Montgomerys are just trying to find their own.
Reigning national champion Maurice Green understands there's more at stake than an individual title.
I believe someone has to step up and, you know, take charge and say that I'm going to put American sprinting back where it's supposed to be, on top, where it has been for so many years.
Will Green be the next American sprinter to stand tall? We've come to Athens to find out. Well, Michael, is Maurice Green capable of being the next 100-meter star?
Whether he's capable or not, I don't know. That's a tremendous amount of pressure for a 23-year-old. He hasn't gotten a lot of experience under his belt. He's had some spotty seasons. He first came on the scene a couple of years ago when he beat Carl Lewis at a small meet at the Texas Relays. He's got a lot of talent, a lot of potential. Whether he's the guy to bring American sprinting back up to the level that it was, I don't know.
Maurice Greene of the U.S. is down in lane one and didn't have the best of starts, but now comes up to take command of the race, and as he approaches the finish line, completely shut it down.
You know, Michael, I've never understood that whole shutting down like that thing. Dropped his arms completely and almost is running backwards by the finish line. That can't be good.
Looked a little nervous, and you can't get injured doing that, but I think it was just that nervous energy. You know, he wanted to get through fast, get the race over with, and shut it down as quick as possible. What you should do is kind of coast down the last 20 or 30 meters when you got a comfortable lead and let your body just kind of coast down like a boat slowing down. That's what my coach always says. But putting on the brakes like that has to put a lot of pressure on your legs, especially at that kind of speed.
He looks real relaxed here, and I know Coach John Smith likes his guys in the rounds to run hard from the blocks for about 65 or 70 meters and then just shut it down and coast in. But I don't think he meant for him to shut it down like this.
And now, Michael, here's your nemesis, Donovan Bailey.
Bailey's never been one of the most consistent sprinters out there, but definitely a big meet performer, gets up for the big meet. It'll be interesting to see how he performs here, being the first time that he's come in as a favorite.
World record holder, set that world record, winning the 100 in Atlanta, anchored the 4x100 relay team that won the gold for Canada. Also won both events at the 95 World Championships. Now keep your eye on the start. Donovan Bailey left in the blocks in lane five. Absolutely left. But he turns it on, joins the leaders, and now knows he will qualify easily. But what a disastrous start for Donovan Bailey. Meanwhile, the man who won the heat, celebrating a victory over Donovan Bailey and setting a Greek national record, Angelos Pavlakis.
Bailey's been talking about an injury lately. I don't know if he was timid at the start trying to carry that leg or if he just didn't react to the gun. A lot of guys come in here a little bit rusty, having taken off the last couple of weeks before this major championship.
And Pavlakakis again celebrating a Greek national record, and even Donovan Bailey can appreciate an accomplishment like that, although that smile may not be too sincere. Now here's Mike Marsh, fifth in the 95 World Championships. He won the 200 in Barcelona, the race that everyone thought Michael Johnson would win, Michael being ill. But look at this, the race being delayed at the start by Alexandros Genovilis of Greece, who just now is showing up. Talk about a distraction at the start. Mike Marsh takes the seat.
I'm not sure if they would allow that if we weren't in Greece.
Everyone finally got safely into the blocks, and here's Mike Marsh hoping to advance in his heat. And Marsh down in lane two, moving to the front and also easily qualifying, moving on from his opening round heat.
Marsh looks very comfortable. He's a guy that you've got to be aware of when he's in the race. Doesn't get a lot of attention, but he's very comfortable here, very relaxed, got a lot of experience. Hasn't been able to find that form that he had in the 200 meters since 1992, but he's done very well in the 100 since then.
Now another American, Tim Montgomery from Virginia Beach, Virginia, making his debut in the 100 and international championship competition.
Montgomery, another one of those young U.S. hopefuls to make his mark here at these championships and become the new man of the U.S. sprinting corps.
Down in lane one, the 22-year-old Montgomery. Pretty good start, and no problem for him as he takes command of the race and wins his opening heat.
Now, Michael, to me, Tim Montgomery looked much more impressive in that first round heat than Maurice Green did. Much more relaxed, and he shut it down the way I think he's supposed to.
He certainly does shut it down correctly. He looks very relaxed here, very light on his feet, comfortably advancing to the next round. He's got his jaws bouncing. Everything's going right here.
Now the man many think will win the gold here, Otto Bolden, representing Trinidad and Tobago. Meanwhile, his friend and training partner Maurice Green down on one knee to watch Otto's opening round heat. Though he represents Trinidad and Tobago, long has lived in the United States, went to college at UCLA. And Bolden is in lane three, and no problem for him. Good start. And easing his way toward the line to also advance. Takes a look behind him. Nobody even close as he completes his race in 10-10.
Excellent race for Bolden. I think what he's doing here is making himself the favorite, which in my opinion makes Donovan Bailey much more dangerous, because he's a much more dangerous competitor when he's not the favorite. Bolden, a great start, very relaxed out. He starts to actually shut it down about 30 meters before he gets to the tape and still runs 10-10.
And Maurice Green, his friend and training partner in Los Angeles, with a congratulatory hug for Otto Bolden. So the key qualifiers, Green, Montgomery, Marsh, Bailey, and Bolden. Frank Fredericks also advancing to the second round. We'll be seeing that second round later.